Jesus Christ is arguably the greatest man who ever lived, but that depends on who you're talking to. There are many scholars who have regarded Christianity as a poison. Scholars like Friedrich Nietzsche, who coined the phrase, "God is dead." But what if Jesus were never born? Would the world really have been better off? Or did the birth of Jesus Christ really save us all? That's the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life. I'm Charlotte Doray. Please kindly do us a favor and hit that subscribe and notification bell so you never miss one of our uploads, and follow the team behind LBQ on social media. Nietzsche wrote in his book, The Antichrist, "I condemn Christianity. I bring against the Christian church the most terrible of all accusations that an accuser has ever had in his mouth. It is to me the greatest of all imaginable corruption. It seeks to work the ultimate corruption, the worst possible corruption." He went on to say the Christian church has left nothing untouched by its depravity. It has turned every value into worthlessness, every truth into a lie, and every integrity into baseness of soul. Those are some pretty savage words, you have to admit. Even for Nietzsche. So if Jesus Christ were never born, according to Nietzsche, the world would have been a much better place, right? Well, again, it kinda depends on who you're talking to. If Jesus had never been born, we sure as heck wouldn't be living in the year 2019. Our yearly calendar began with Jesus' birth 2019 years ago. If Jesus were never born, we would have continued to use the system put in place by Dionysius Exiguus, who invented our current system in 525 AD. Without another dating method to replace it, we would be currently living in the year 1734 Diocletian. Either that or a different areas of the world that follow different religions would be following their own calendars. AM 5774 in the Hebrew calendar, 1725 Coptic, a variation of the Egyptian calendarium. There are separate calendars in China, Japan, there's a separate Hindu calendar, and several others in Africa. The point is, without the birth of Jesus Christ, we wouldn't be in the year 2019. If Jesus were never born, ancient religions would not have been replaced by Christianity. There are many other religions, many of which people choose to follow instead of Christianity. Without Christianity, the Roman Empire would have continued on to dominate much of the world without Christian doctrine. Rome would have continued to worship their pagan gods. Romans weren't too bothered about people practicing other religions within their empire, so people belonging to different religions would have continued to practice whatever religions they wanted. Christianity also did a lot of good things for the world too. Hospitals began during the Middle Ages, and they were Christian institutions. Universities started popping up in the Middle Ages as well, and the masses, who were illiterate and did not have access to education, started reading books. Mainly the Bible. In the Middle Ages, churches and cathedrals were the core of their cities. Churches and cathedrals are where civilians would come together to hear music and the word of God. We would not have breathtaking buildings like the Duomo Cathedral in Milan, the Vatican, or the Notre Dame Cathedral. Sadly, that last one is a bit of a bummer to bring up now, but you get my point. Yet for all the good Christianity has done for the world, many, many people have done horrible things in the name of Jesus Christ, and many people have died in his name as well. If Jesus were never born, every horrible thing that had ever happened over the course of history that was done in the name of Jesus Christ would never have occurred. There sure as heck wouldn't have been any crusades where Christian missionaries slaughtered much of Europe in the name of Christianity. There wouldn't have been witch burnings because there would have been no such thing as a heretic. Homosexuals would not have been persecuted in the same way because homosexuality would not have been regarded as a perversion. In ancient Rome, homosexuality was somewhat common and it wasn't seen as a sexual perversion. There were several Roman emperors who were rumored to have been homosexual. Augustus, Tiberius, Nero, Hadrian, and quite possibly others had calamites, which was a term to describe young, pretty male slaves kept as somewhat playthings. Yet when Christianity started to spread in the first century AD, homosexual tendencies were frowned upon and even persecuted. Without the birth of Christ, the world might have a much more accepting view of homosexuals today. When you watch movies and TV shows that take place in the Middle Ages, or even up to just a few decades ago, do you ever notice how many of the characters are motivated by religious factors? "God told me to do it," they say. "God wishes it. God has chosen me." Think about how many people would have lived, how many children would not have been assaulted by priests without the Holy Bible to manipulate people into doing their bidding. It's difficult to encapsulate in a short video just how different the world would be today if Jesus Christ were never born. Christianity has changed humanity forever, for the good, for the bad, and everything in between. How do you think the world would be different if Jesus Christ were never born? Let me know in those comments. For now, I'm gonna respond to some comments from my last video on this channel. What if the oxygen on Earth decreased by half? Jack Carroll said, "I love how different Charlotte is in IO versus LBQ. She's so calm here, but on Informal Overload, she's so hyper. I'm like a chameleon. I can do all the things." By the way, in case you didn't know, I also host another channel, Informal Overload. We do the news and we make it entertaining, so please come by and say hi. Green Polo Boy said, "What if we got sick and tired of asking questions?" Well, I would imagine you'd be a whole lot dumber. Lacken said, "Boom, you just earned a subscriber. You're welcome and may God bless you." I may have just lost your subscription thanks to this video, but I hope all the Christians watching are open to discussion. That is it for for me. Thank you for watching. If you want to keep watching, check out the playlist that's currently flashing on your screen. And don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so I can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.